Welcome. Welcome to St. John the Divine Episcopal Church and this online service of Advent lessons and carols. Advent is a season of both quiet reflection and joyful expectation. This service is intended to be a time of spiritual preparation as we watch and wait for the coming of the Kingdom of God. Through our experience of sacred word and music, the story of the coming of Christ gradually unfolds and deepens our understanding of God's message of love and redemption. The liturgy itself embodies the sense of Advent movement, beginning from the procession and increasingly powerful prophecies and promises of Holy Scriptures. May these words, the music, and the prayers propel you quietly toward the joy of Christmas. Have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. the season of Advent, it is our responsibility and joy to prepare ourselves to hear once more the message of the angels, to go even to Bethlehem and see the Son of God lying in a manger. Let us hear and heed in Holy Scriptures the story of God's loving purpose from the time of our rebellion against Him until the glorious redemption brought to us by His Holy Child, Jesus. And let us look forward to the yearly remembrance of His birth with hymns and songs of praise.
But first, let us pray for the needs of the whole world, for peace and justice on earth, for the unity and mission of the Church for which He died, and especially for His Church in our country and in this city. And because He particularly loves them, let us remember in His name the poor and the hopeless, the cold, the hungry and the oppressed, the sick and those who mourn, the lonely and the unloved, the aged and the little children, as well as those who do not know and love the Lord Jesus Christ.
Finally, let us remember before God His pure and lowly mother, and that whole multitude which no one can number, whose hope was in the Word made flesh, and whom, in Jesus, we are one forevermore. And now to sum up all these petitions, let us pray in the words which Christ Himself has taught us.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
The Almighty God bless us with His grace. Christ Jesus guide us to follow His path, and the Holy Spirit strengthen us for love and service. Amen.
The first lesson is from the book of Genesis. Adam and Eve rebel against God and are cast out of the Garden of Eden. Now the serpent was more crafty than any other wild animal that the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, "Did God say you shall not eat from any tree in the garden?" The woman said to the serpent, "We may eat of the fruit of the trees in the garden. But God said, you shall not eat of the fruit of the tree that is in the middle of the garden, nor shall you touch it, or you shall die." But the serpent said to the woman, "You will not die, for God knows that when you eat of it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil." So when the woman saw that the tree was good for food, and that it was a delight to the eyes, and that the tree was to be desired to make one wise, she took of its fruit and ate. And she also gave some to her husband, who was with her, and he ate. Then the eyes of both were opened, and they knew that they were naked. And they sewed fig leaves together and made loincloths for themselves. They heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden at the time of the evening breeze. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man and said to him, "Where are you?" He said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." He said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" The man said, "The woman whom you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit from the tree and I ate." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this that you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent tricked me and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you among all animals and among all wild creatures. Upon your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and hers. He will strike your head, and you will strike his heel." This is the word of the Lord.
Second lesson, Isaiah chapter 40. God comforts his people and calls on them to prepare for redemption. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I say, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Get you up to a high mountain, O Zion, herald of good tidings. Lift up your voice with strength, O Jerusalem, herald of good tidings. Lift it up, do not fear, say the cities of Judah. Here is your God. See, the Lord God comes with might, and his arm rules for him. His reward is with him, and his recompense before him. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom and gently lead the mother sheep.
lesson, Jeremiah 31:31-34. A new covenant is promised, which will be written in our hearts. The days are surely coming, says the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and the house of Judah. It will not be the covenant that I made with their ancestors when I took them by the hand to bring them out of the land of Egypt, a covenant that they broke, though I was their husband, says the Lord. But this is the covenant that I will make with the house of Israel. After those days, says the Lord, I will put my law within them, and I will write it on their hearts, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. No longer shall they teach one another or say to each other, Know the Lord. For they shall all know me, from the least of them to the greatest, says the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity and remember their sin no more.
Thank you. The fourth lesson. The one who is to rule Israel will be born in the village of Bethlehem. But you, O Bethlehem of Ephrathah, who are once of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth for me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from of old, from ancient days. Therefore, he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the ends of the earth. The word of the Lord.
Mga kanta'y manong esiyan, mga kanta'y tayo pumasilebra, pinato niya.
Lesson, Isaiah chapter 35. The prophet proclaims that God will come and save us. The wilderness and the dry land shall be glad. The desert shall rejoice and blossom. Like the crocus, it shall blossom abundantly and rejoice with joy and singing. The glory of Lebanon shall be given to it, the majesty of Carmel and Sharon. They shall see the glory of the Lord, the majesty of our God. Strengthen the weak hands and make firm the feeble knees. Say to those who are of a fearful heart, be strong, do not fear. Here is your God. He will come with vengeance, with terrible recompense. He will come and save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened and the ears of the deaf unstopped. Then the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongue of the speechless sing for joy. For water shall break forth in the wilderness, and streams in the desert. The burning sand shall become a pool, and the thirsty ground springs of water. The hunt of jackals shall become a swamp. The grass shall become reeds and rushes. A highway shall be there, and it shall be called the Holy Way. The unclean shall not travel on it, but it shall be for God's people. No traveler, not even fools, shall go astray. No lion shall be there, nor shall any ravenous beast come upon it. They shall be not found there, but the redeemed shall walk there, and the ransom of the Lord shall return and come to Zion with singing. Everlasting joy shall be upon their heads. They shall obtain joy and gladness, and sorrow and sighing shall flee away.
Oh, Lord, God's love. The sixth lesson, Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 14 to 18. The Lord will be among us. We are summoned to rejoice and sing. Sing aloud, O daughter Zion. Shout, O Israel. Rejoice and exult with all your heart. O daughter Jerusalem, the Lord has taken away the judgments against you. He has turned away your enemies, the King of Israel. The Lord is in your midst. You shall fear disaster no more. On that day, it shall be said to Jerusalem, do not fear. O Zion, do not let your hands grow weak. The Lord your God is in your midst, a warrior who gives victory. He will rejoice over you with gladness. He will renew you in his love. He will exult over you with loud singing, as on a day of festival. I will remove disaster from you, so that you will not bear reproach for it. We thank you, Lord.
Lesson, Luke 1:26 through 38. The angel Gabriel announces to the Virgin Mary that she will bear the Son of the Most High. In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth, to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and he came to her and said,
"Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you."
But she was much perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greetings this might be. The angel said to her,
"Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and his kingdom there will be no end," Mary said to the angel.
"How can this be, since I am a virgin?"
The angel said to her,
"The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called Son of God. And now your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son. And this is the sixth month for her who has said to be barren, for nothing will be impossible with God."
Then Mary said,
"Here I am, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word."
Then the angels departed from her.
Most highly favored. Shall see the salvation of the Lord.
Tomorrow go ye forth, and the Lord, he will be with you.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Ghost.
Tomorrow go ye forth, and the Lord, he will be with you.
We wait for your loving kindness, O Lord.
In the midst of your temple.
O Lord our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful as we await the coming of your Son, our Lord. That, when he shall appear, he may not find us sleeping in sin, but active in his service and joyful in his praise. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
Sisters and brothers, may the light of Christ lead you to the joys of God's kingdom, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.